Hello, it's Kat, and in today's video, I'm going to be sharing my first impressions of Adobe Firefly. I just got access to the beta today, so I want to go over a couple of the features, a couple of the upcoming experimentations they're working on, and what this might mean for illustrators in the future. So I know that AI art in general can make us as artists and designers very nervous, and that's completely understandable, definitely something that I feel from time to time. With Firefly in particular, I'm really excited about the possibilities here because what they seem to be leaning on is integrating these tools into our Adobe apps and really just giving us better tools to be creative faster. I've put a link in the description below to the official livestream announcement, but I just want to kind of summarize and go over quickly the most interesting points that have the potential to affect us as vector artists in particular. But first, really quickly, if you're wondering what Firefly is, it's a family of creative generative AI models. If that still doesn't help, if you've heard of Midjourney or Dall-e, it's basically something similar to that where you can type in a text prompt and get an image generated by AI. There's a couple of things right off the bat that differentiate Firefly from those other tools. One of them is definitely the UI. I have tried experimenting with Midjourney and Dall-e, as well as other AI image models, and I've found making text prompts to be not so intuitive. I love the fact that you can type in a prompt with Firefly, and then you have all of these filters and effects and parameters that you can put on an image just by clicking a few buttons. So essentially, it's building those things into your prompt, and you're not ending up with paragraph-sized text prompts like you could with Midjourney to get a really nice result. You can see me experimenting with some prompts in the background here. It's been really fun so far. And I just want to mention really quickly that this is not a sponsored post and I don't work for Adobe. So once you're on the home screen here of Adobe Firefly, you've got two models to choose from that are actually live. Then we've got one model that's coming soon, and they've also listed some models that are under experimentation.
So they list one up here that's recolor vectors coming soon, and I'm quite excited about that. What I'm picturing is a really enhanced version of recolor artwork that we already have in Illustrator. And then if you scroll down past some of the exploration and examples, you've got a few more models here that they're working on. So a couple of the most interesting are text to vector. One that is really interesting for pattern makers will be text to pattern. And I personally love making brushes. I've got a bunch of brush videos on my channel already. And so text to brush, I am dying to play with that. Sketch to image sounds really interesting. And they have said that not all of these models are necessarily going to be released. These are just things that they're experimenting with, and they're putting them out there basically to be transparent with what they're working on, what they're experimenting with. And they're trying to gather as much feedback as they can from creatives. So going back to the models that are live now, let's just go ahead and do a quick text to image. And we just go ahead and click generate here, and you'll get all of these samples that are already made. And you can actually click on any of these and do try prompt. So let's look at that. If I say try prompt here, you can see which styles were applied. And this is really interesting. And you can see the exact prompt that was used. Now, the interface, as I mentioned, is definitely a differentiating factor. A lot of the other image AI text to image models, you just have to go ahead and create these wild prompts with all of these keywords, and you don't necessarily know under the hood what's the best word to use to get the best style. So Adobe's brought that all out into the front on the UI, and you can even do things like define an aspect ratio, which will be really handy if you're going to use it in a design. You can pick a style here. There are tons of styles and effects that you can choose from. This is essentially like adding filters that you would add in Photoshop, and obviously Adobe has a ton of this technology built up over the years that they've already integrated into their apps, and now we can just click these buttons to start applying anything to your prompts. You can even change colors and tones, generating something like black and white images, cool tones, etc. Lighting is a really interesting one. I've played with that just a little bit, and composition as well. So if we go into these images that have been generated, we can click a show similar button to see more. There are options here to submit to gallery, use as a reference, copy to clipboard, or download. If you download at this point, I just do want to note that you will get the Firefly watermark, and you should not be using these images commercially yet. In the beta, everything is non-commercial. This is really just for testing purposes, so something to keep in mind. So the second model that's already live that you can go ahead and start generating with is the text effects. And again, you'll see some samples on this homepage. Some of them are really wild. I kind of love these mossy natural ones and shaggy fur ones. So they do have some sample effects that you can try when you come in here. It will take a moment to generate. And you can change the font. I'm going to change the effect here to flowers. You can change how closely these effects fit to the letters. So that's always an interesting one. If we go loose, that'll give you a whole different effect. And you have a few fonts to choose from here. If you click view all, you'll get a few more. I assume that this will expand as time goes on. Right now, there's not a huge amount to choose from. And of course, most of them are pretty bold so that you can apply effects like these. You can also change background color, and text color, I believe, will change the base. This is regenerating now, so we'll see if that affects anything. It doesn't look like it did, so I'm not quite sure how that works yet, but we'll keep experimenting and see. At the very end of the official live stream, there was a short trailer that showcased the coming soon models. I'm going to link to the timestamp down below for that. But like I said, those vector features are very interesting, especially the patterns and the brushes and things like that. So it looks like what we're going to get eventually are tools that are integrated right into Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Photoshop and the tools that you're used to using, but with these extra features that incorporate AI so that it's more of a collaborative process between the artist and the AI. One of the other interesting points that they covered in the announcement video was how they are working to make Adobe Firefly a commercially safe model. If you've seen the news, of course, there's some legal issues floating around with the use of AI images depending on how the models were trained. The Adobe Firefly models are trained on Adobe stock images, which are commercially licensable, as well as public domain images that are out of copyright. And they do have a section on their website here under the FAQs that tells you more about that. And apparently there is a way that you can turn off your images being part of the model. So Adobe is working to advocate for artists being able to use a do not train tag so that your art doesn't go into these public facing models if that's not something that you want. I'll be doing some more research on that and probably a follow up video to talk a little bit more about that and how it affects us as Adobe stock contributors directly. On that note of what's going into the model to train it and what's not, one of the really exciting things that they mentioned the possibility of is giving us models that we can train using our own artwork that would likely be private and possibly even monetizing that model in the future. I'm going to link to the timestamp and a couple of quotes on this that happened in the live stream so that you can go back and watch that part if you're interested in more details. I would absolutely love to hear what you guys think about this, if you have any questions, what your feedback is. I do plan to do a follow-up video and possibly reach out and have some questions answered, so give me some ideas in the comments below. I hope you guys have a great day. As always, happy illustrating.